Wasteland 2 on Nintendo Switch is a game that, if you can forgive its compromises and get over it, it will result in one of the most enjoyable, rewarding, sometimes frustrating, but always enjoyable role-playing games on Nintendo's handheld system or hybrid system. Wasteland 2, though, you can tell right off the bat it was made for PC, which means compromises come in many, many ways, from the visuals, which for Nintendo Switch, having played other games on it, is vastly underwhelming. It's meant to be a wasteland, but it just looks very, sometimes very empty, and in other times very grungy and not in the right way. However, you can kind of get over that after a bit of time, but then there are performance issues where the game will chug often enough, but it will hit a few times, and it's another compromise you just kind of have to get used to, as well as the UI, which at times can feel unmanageable. It's laggy, there are delayed inputs, and it's all these things I say up front is because if you are particularly picky about any of those, you may have enough of this game before it really gives you everything it has and makes it one of the most enjoyable open world games out there. Because if you can get past all that, you have an incredibly free roaming, interesting world to explore, filled with many characters and locations and a bunch of trouble you can get yourself up to be honest. And that's sort of one of the things that make this game so special is you don't really feel like you have a really, really strict story to stick to. You can go out and explore. And just find some crazy stuff and get some cool gear and loot. But always, always, supplies are limited. Guns are limited, ammo is limited, and at the start you'll feel that at most, as you sort of gotta be careful about when you shoot. To always have a backup weapon, maybe it's melee, and just always make sure that everyone is distributing the ammo correctly, or at least you are using it correctly, because you could come up against something and not have enough ammo, and yeah, that can't be good whatsoever. However, you sort of enjoy that part of it. That is what Wasteland should feel like, right? It should feel restrictive and sacrificial in a lot of ways, and it does that so well. It's just hidden in, or not hidden, but it's just kind of co-opted with a UI that doesn't work really well on the controllers. It's too cumbersome. It's very tough to wrap your head around that in the beginning. And then when you finally do, it's slow and sluggish. However, I still would recommend this game to any open world fan, any fan of the post-apocalyptic future or wasteland or anything like that. I thoroughly enjoyed my time with this. This is just such a unique game in the sense that sure, you could compare it to things like Fallout, which basically Fallout came from the original Wasteland, but it adds so much more to it. I think you're not going to get a turn-based RPG game quite like this on Nintendo system particularly, but if you can, I would probably suggest you play this game on elsewhere, preferably on a PC. It runs pretty well on PC. Here on Nintendo Switch, it doesn't look great. It doesn't run great. It can be frustrating just to control. So I would say get this game if you only have a Nintendo Switch and you don't have a PC. Otherwise, don't get the Switch version. Get the PC version and enjoy your time a lot more there. The game works fine for the handheld nature, but it's not particularly built for, or at least isn't enhanced by the fact that you can bring it with you. This is a game you can sit there and play for hours on end. And if you can do that in front of a PC, I would suggest that. But otherwise, it's a fascinating game. I would suggest and recommend you play this game no matter what. That's the thing I say. Whether it's on Switch or PC will come up to your situation. But either way, this is a game well worth playing no matter what platform it's on. No